The tool that I use a lot is mental conversations or mental programming. When we're raised between 0 and 7 years old, we are in theta brainwave, which is essentially hypnosis. Or when we see things happening, it implants in our brain as, okay, this is a rule. This is what always has to happen. So when we grow up, and when we're an adult, and when we get into relationships or friendships even, when something happens, our brain, because of the programming from childhood, our brain will go into, oh, okay, so that's a rule. So this is always going to happen. So when we have these mental conversations, that begins these mental conversations with people in our lives. And when they do something once, we assume, we conclude, we expect that that's like a rule and that's going to continue happening. That creates these mental conversations with the people in our lives where we're beginning to, from the get-go, we wake up in the morning and we expect people in our lives to do certain things. And that doesn't give anything in our lives room to manipulate or move. So when we start having different mental conversations in our mind with people in our lives, and we start playing with this and we start asking questions, and these questions will ask our reticular activating system in our brain, and this will begin to create change and change the not only the mental conversations that we're having in our brain to allow that space, but it allows the other people in our lives to change the way they react with us and to us and have these conversations and relationships. Whenever there's a dissatisfaction, I want you to write down in a journal or whatever you want. I'm creating a journal for this. It's just not out yet. But you can change. So you write down your dissatisfaction. So I'm not in control. That's a big one. You write that down. That's a dissatisfaction. And you're going to flip that into the positive. You're going to flip that into what you desire, what you want, which is easy. I am in control. You can implant this into different areas of your life. So I am in control of my money. I'm in control of my relationships. I'm in control of my friendships. I'm in control of my free time. I'm in control of my health. All of these things in our lives that we feel like we don't have control over. From 0 to 7, that's 7 years of being in hypnosis, where our brain has created these rules. And a lot of people say that these rules kind of create these lenses, like these glasses that we look through and create our reality through. So when we feel deep down to our core that we're not in control, and then somebody like me comes around and goes, okay, we'll just flip the switch and flip the mental conversation that you're having and tell your brain, yeah, I am in control. What are you doing telling me just to say to yourself, see myself, I'm in control when I feel like I'm not in control? It's not that easy. And that's where the fun stuff begins, because then when we start to tell ourselves, so when you start saying, I am in control, there's a part of your body that's going to go, you're crazy. No, I'm not. View that reaction. So your body, your emotions are feedback. As Dr. Joe Dispenza says, your body is your subconscious mind. So when we think, when we react to a trigger in our life of, I'm not in control, we see something and our mind goes, see, that's proving to me that I'm not in control. So our mind, our mental body, is like going down this track, this pathway, this way, I'm not in control, coming to that conclusion. And it's up to us to go, I'm going this way. And it's honestly taking your mind and going, I understand that was 5 minutes ago. But for the next 10 seconds, I'm focusing on this way. I am in control. And it's just reminding your brain and switching it from, if that was 5 minutes ago, we're going this way now. And it's like a muscle memory. But when we start to say, I am in control, then things like the inner child will come up. The inner child will say, is that safe? Can I really think and believe that I'm in control? Does that feel safe to me? The victim will say, there's past trauma here. What past trauma does this remind me of? Does ruining this new thought process, this new path, does ruining that benefit me more than allowing it? What will this cost me? Will it cost me more time? Will it cost me more to believe this new pathway? So our job is, when these come up, we can ask the question, what is that old story creating? Versus, what is this new story creating? If I want to believe and create from the perspective of I am in control, what will that create?